Yo, what up sa inyo lahat? WB Mileto. Ang tayo mula dito sa ating video reaction na sa ating news reaction na kung sana andito tayo sa Balita na Iwan. Subscribe ka dyan mga kabalits. At ito na nga mga kabalits, pulong ang hatol, binasahan na ng korte. Grabe, general laban sa general PNP chief tumimbre sa Pogo. At yun, paalala lamang, ito at reaction video lamang. Anong sumasala round dito, bahagi lamang natin reaction video. Bahala na kayo kung maniniwala kayo o hindi. At yun, play na natin.
General Karamat, siya na naman. General Karamat, you have to stay here. Sit down. Please. Again, reminder. General Karamat, please, reminder po. Huwag po tayo magsisinungaling sa hearing na to.
Do you know the mayor of Sual Pangasinan?
Yes, Your Honor.
At you are very close with him, together with retired General Ronald Lee. Would that be correct?
I cannot answer for General Ronald Lee, sir.
May mga pictures kayo eh. Would you still deny that?
I could only answer for myself, sir.
El Karamat.
Yes, sir.
Would you know if the mayor of Sual Pangasinan really the boyfriend of Madam Mayor Alice?
The same, sir. I could give my answer based on evidence, sir.
El Karamat, maraming marites eh. Nakakarating po dito sa Maynila. Ano pa kaya?
So, dalawang relief ang ginawa mo. Ang tanong natin nga kanina, tinatanong ni ano, tinatanong ko rin, why is it that after the successful operation, after a day, nirelieve natin si Colonel Alejandro at Colonel George Buyacao ay nirelieve din during your time? Why? Hindi ko talaga makomprehend kung bakit yung nirelieve eh. Yung mga tao, pagkatapos, imbis na bigyan natin sila ng pabuya. Di ba?
Nahuling tumimbre kay Mayor Alice Guo si General Karamat bago mangyari ang raid. At huling kaibigan din kasi ni General ang mayor ng Pangasinan na boyfriend din pala ni Mayor Alice Guo, kung kaya't nakatakas siya sa raid dahil may timbre na galing sa Sual. Batay naman kay Congressman Romeo Acop na dating ex-general. Hinahamon kita, General Karamat, general sa general. At huwag kang magsisinuwaling dito dahil meron akong hawak sa inyong litrato. Nakasama mo si retired General Ronald Lee at si Mayor Alice Guo, kaya wag mo na ditong ide-deny na hindi ikaw ang nagtimbre sa boyfriend niya ng raid. Alam naming tinimbre mo ang raid na gagawin sa Pogo Hub. Para sa mga hindi nakakaalam, nagalit kay General Karamat ang mga pulis matapos nilang sibakin lahat ng CIDG na matitinong pulis na mga nag-raid sa Bambantarlak. Ngunit dawit daw kasi dito ang PNP chief, inutusan daw kasi silang sibakin lahat ng nag-raid sa Pogo Hub.
Do you know the mayor of Sual Pangasinan?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. And how close are you with him?
Being a former policeman, I know him as a colleague also, as a police, sir.
But you are very close with him, together with retired General Ronald Lee. Would that be correct?
I cannot answer for General Ronald Lee, sir.
Well, as a while ago, may mga pictures kayo eh. Kaya na tinta ng chairman kanina. Ako, I have picture. Would you still deny that?
I could only answer for myself, sir. But I suppose General Lee was once the provincial director in Bulacan. I'm in Pangasinan, sir, so I suppose he knows him, sir.
Yes. Kikita-kita kayo eh. Diba?
That's correct, Your Honor.
Yes. Kaya huwag ka na magsinungaling. Marami nang naipadala sa akin na information eh. So the reason why Colonel Alejandro after the raid in Bamban was issued because meron ng plano na i-reshuffle. That's your official answer?
Yes, Your Honor, sir.
And you think this administration would believe that?
Come again, Your Honor, sir.
And you think this representation, eh, paniniwalaan po yun, sinabi nyo?
I believe so, sir, because I was the one who authorized that operation in Banban. I give them clearance, sir. So, there is no reason na talagang i-relieve ko dahil dun sa operation nila. Dahil ako mismo ang nagbigay ng clearance sa operations na yun.
Wait. I'm sorry, Chairman, ako. Because a while ago, you were telling us that you were on leave. Now, sinasabi mo...
That was a different operation, Your Honor, sir.
No, no, no. Wait. You told us that on February 1, during the operation of Colonel Alejandro, you were on leave.
No, sir. During the operation of Colonel Buyacao, that I was on leave.
You were on leave also?
No, no, sir. No, sir. I did not say that.
Anyway, Comsec, can you kindly backtrack the video? We wanted to find out. But for the meantime, you go ahead, Congressman Chairman Acop. Again, reminder, General Karamat, reminder po, huwag po tayo magsisinungaling sa hearing na to. Go ahead, Congressman Acop.
El Karamat.
Yes, sir.
Would you know if the mayor of Sual Pangasinan really the boyfriend of Madam Mayor Alice, not Congressman Batawil or Mayor Batawil, as insinuated by the Honorable Abante?
The same, sir. I could give my answer based on evidence, sir.
Based on evidence. And what you're trying to tell this representation and the committee is that you do not have any evidence.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Insya. Del Karamat, maraming marites eh. Nakakarating po dito sa Maynila. Ano pa kaya? Ano ba?
I will stick with my answer, Your Honor, sir, that I have no evidence, sir.
Okay. Kasi, titingnan po ninyo kasi, yung pagtatanong ko kay Yusek Cruz, definitely nagkaroon ng leakage, yun ang statement niya. Saan po kaya manggagaling yung leakage kundi dun sa mga nakakaalam na merong operation against Ibamban Poguhab? Di po ba?
Sir, the operation...
You are an investigator. Alam mo na yung mga connections na yun.
Sir, I was not informed on that operation, sir. I was on leave abroad, sir. Zero knowledge talaga kami, sir. Even my command group, sir, were not informed of that operation, sir.
Yeah. Jose Cruz, why were the two search warrants to secure for such an operation?
For the Banban operation, Your Honor?
Yes.
Yes, Your Honor. There were two search warrants.
Why?
Malaki po kasi, sir, yung compound. So, we need to use two search warrants.
There were 36 buildings in that 9-hectare or 10-hectare property, right?
About 10 hectares, Your Honor.
No. Have you asked Pagkor kung lahat po ng building o yung operations doon ay may lisensya lahat?
Ang kwento po sa amin, sir,
Pagkor kung may lisensya lahat yung 36 buildings na yun?
We were told that only one building that's at the second, third, fourth, and fifth floor lang, sir, yung may license. We did two search warrants, Your Honor, kasi where the owner or maybe the operator during that time think that we will be raiding lang, sir, yung isang building. But what we did, sir, is we applied for the whole compound. So, kasi sir, alam namin yung pinakikitang building sa Pagkor is the building that they want to be inspected because wala kang makikita talaga doon, sir. It's like they are pulling all the inspectors with that building. So what we did, we applied for the whole compound, sir. So we can get yung mga scam farms nila, sir.
May ask the Undersecretary, when was the raid of Pamban conducted?
Your Honor, it's March 13, 2024, Your Honor.
March 13?
Yes, sir.
Would it be true that the information that you had a meeting for March 13 in a certain camp in Region 3?
What particular meeting, Your Honor?
Did you have a meeting at Camp General Servilio Aquino of the Northern Luzon Command before the raid?
Before the raid, yes, sir. Sa Nolcom po, sir, meron.
Yeah. That's the question that I...
Yes, sir. Meron po, sir.
And in that meeting, informations were received by your office na lumalabas na yung mga tao doon sa Pogo Hub sa Bamban. Would that be correct?
Yes, sir. That's true, Your Honor.
Yes, that's true. And because of that, inapuran nyo na yung pag-conduct nyo ng raid.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I know. What were the expected, or what was the expected number of people that you would find in Pogo Hub?
During our pre-op, sir, we're expecting around 1,000 to 1,500 foreign nationals ang dadatnan po namin, sir.
And how many were you able to arrest?
Sa record po namin, sir, about mga nasa 300 na lang po, sir, yung mga dinat na namin, mga foreign national.
So, what was in your mind then?
Definitely, sir, nagkaroon po ng leakage.
Definitely?
Yes, sir.
Sagot po nyo sa akin, definitely.
Yes, sir, definitely, leakage. Sir.
Kaya kumunti yung naratna ninyo.
Yes, sir.
May I ask if Gerald Karamat is still here?
Present, Your Honor.
Narinig mo yung sagot ni Jose Cruz doon sa Juan sa tanong ko.
Yes, sir.
Na definitely nagkaroon ng leakage noong March 13 na operation, which included the Office of the Criminal Investigation and Detection. Tama?
Yes, I heard, Your Honor.
Okay. Now, dahilan doon sa isang raid kung bakit yung bang Bamban na Jose Cruz yung elements ng CIDG galing na sa Regions 1 in Cordillera?
Yes, sir. Actually, kaya po na-delay, Your Honor, yung pagdating ng elements from the Region 1, sir, dahil medyo malayo po, sir. So that's why we need to yung grupo na lang namin, sir, ang talaga nagtulong-tulong para maisara, sir, yung mga lalabasan, sir, ng mga nasa Pogo Hubs.
But the participating units knew of the raid?
Yes, sir. Kasama po namin, sir, yung CIDG nun, sir. Yes, sir.
Nung CIDG elements from where?
NCR, sir.
Here. Thank you. There was also a raid conducted on the same area by the CIDG alone. Tama po ba? I think that was katanong kanina, that was February 1 ba?
That's 2023, Your Honor.
Yes. Yun yung tanong ni Honorable Busita na CIDG lang ang nag-operate. Tama po?
That's what I heard, Your Honor.
Yes. Tama rin po ba, Gerald Karamat?
That's correct, Your Honor.
Yes. And ang nag-lead ng raid, tatanong ni Gerald Busita, I understand it, si Colonel Alejandro?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. At after the raid, na-relieve siya?
Yes, Your Honor.
Pero hindi pa ikaw ang CIDG head?
I was already the CIDG head, sir.
You were already the CIDG.
Yes, sir.
Para maklarify, kasi magulo kanina yung pagtatanong. Diba? So you were already the CIDG head when Colonel Alejandro raided yung Pogo Hub sa Bamban, Tarlac in February of 2023.
That's correct, Your Honor, sir.
Now, let's go back to the question of the Honorable Busita. Magulo kanina. So far time. Yan lang sa question na yun eh. Issue na yan. You relieved Colonel Alejandro how many days after the raid?
A day after the operation, sir.
A day after the operation.
Yes, sir.
Now, Honorable Busita did not ask you the reason why I'm asking you the reason why the day after the operation you relieved the head of, or the team which operated against the Pogo Hub in Pampanga.
Yes, sir, because there was already scheduled a revamp among all my commanders, sir. Actually, it was not Colonel Alejandro was that was issued order on that day. There were several regional commanders who were included in that reshuffle, sir.
Hey, executive, with the indulgence of Congressman Rosita, kaprasa na lang po. I just wanted to find out why all of the sudden, napaltan agad si si Buyakao. And as a matter of fact, kanina sinasabi mo that there is a certain Colonel Busita, Colonel Busita, Alejandro also?
Yes, Mr. Chair, after operation ng CIDG3 headed by Colonel Alejandro, the following day, ni-relieve din po siya eh.
So, ang nag-relieve dito, during that time ng February 2, 2023 is not CPNP Marbil. This is during the time of Acorda. And who is the CIDG chief during this time?
All this time, General Karamat, Mr.
General Karamat. Siya na naman. General Karamat, you have to stay here. Sit down, please. So, dalawang relief ang ginawa mo. Isa nung February 2 with Colonel Alejandro and the other one is with Colonel Buyakao. After all the successful operation, what I heard from Colonel Busita, Congressman Busita, parehong-pareho that nag-operate, naging successful, tapos nire-relief. Pero, different CPNP. Am I correct, General Karamat?
Dr. John, Mr. Chairman, sir. No, sir. I was not, to clarify the matter, sir, I was not the one who relieved Colonel Buyakao. But in the case of Colonel Alejandro...
Wait. General, ikaw ang chief CIDG.
Yes, sir.
So, it's command responsibility. Oh, ikaw pa rin nag-sign. But there are orders coming from the higher ups. Is that what you're trying to say?
That's correct, Your Honor.
So, during these two instances wherein the first nare-relieve si Colonel Alejandro and Colonel Buyakao, ikaw ang CID Chief.
That's correct, Mr. Chairman, sir.
Yes, that's the reason why your answer is wrong when you say no. So, ibig sabihin, ikaw ang pumirma, pero may utos sa taas. Ganun ba yan?
That's correct again, Your Honor.
Okay. So now, going back to the interpellation of Congressman Busita, we are just wondering, dahil tong panahon ni Alejandro, February 2, 2023, ang CPNP dito ay si Acorda. Am I correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
And during the relief of Colonel George Buyakao, it was already CPNP Marbil.
Correct, Your Honor.
That's it. Correct. So now, and during these two incidents, you are the chief CIDG. Am I correct?
Correct, Your Honor.
Ayan. Oh, so, ikaw yung common denominator dito sa pag-relieve ng dalawang grupong ito. Ang tanong natin nga kanina, tinatanong ko rin, why is it that after the successful operation, after a day, nirelieve natin si Colonel Alejandro at ito namang si Colonel George Buyakao ay nirelieve din during your time? Why?
Thank you, Your Honor. Let me clarify my position, sir.
Go ahead.
In the case of Colonel Alejandro, the cause of his relief has no connection to the operation of Banban before the operation in Bamban last February 2023, Colonel Alejandro was already informed of the impending reshuffle of all the regional of some regional chief of the CIDG. So he was informed already before the raid in Bamban happened, sir. So it was a normal rotation of all my regional chiefs because as a commander then, newly assigned commander or director of CIDG, I have to put in place my commanders whom I have the trust and confidence, sir.
Okay. So, General Karamat, kailan ka po na na-appoint bilang chief CIDG?
January 1, 2023.
And when was the operation of the operation doon sa Bamban?
February 2023. And in fact,
wait, General Karamat.
Yes, sir.
So you were appointed as CIDG, na-assign ka January 2023.
Yes, sir.
February 1, nagkaroon ng operation. And then February 2, na-relieve si Colonel Alejandro.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Si Alejandro, ang position niya during that time is
Regional Chief of CIDG Region 3, sir.
Okay, Region 3. Am I correct to assume that during that operation, it was the Region 1 who augmented the operation?
That's a different operation, sir.
Kailan nag-augment ang Region 1 instead of Region 3? Kasi I have a report here that's telling us that the operation that was conducted, augmentation nang galing sa Region 1, hindi sa Region 3.
That was the operation led by the PAOK and Colonel Boyacao, sir.
And this is during the time of General Acorda, am I correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
But hindi kinuha sa Region 3? Ni Acorda?
That I cannot answer, sir. That's the wisdom
is it,
of...
Is it a trust and confidence situation?
I think so, Your Honor.
And that's the reason why Region 1 ang pinadalang augmentation imbis na Region 3. Why that's Region 3?
Again, I cannot answer that. I don't want to speculate. I don't want to question
you,
the wisdom of din.
Ikaw
ang anong
CIDG noon, ah? Ikaw CIDG, you should know.
To inform this committee, the operation in Bamban that was led by Colonel Boyacao, I was on leave I was not even informed of that operation. Even my command group was not informed.
So, hindi ka na-inform ng higher-ups doon sa operation ng Bamban?
That's correct, Your Honor.
And the reason why is?
I was on leave.
On leave?
Yes, sir. I was on leave abroad.
So in other words, kaya nagkaroon ng augmentation ng Region 1?
Again, I cannot answer that.
Kasi alam mo, nagtatalo isip po dito, bakit gagamitin ng Region 1 instead of Region 3? Precisely, yun yung kanilang area of jurisdiction. And I think we need to ask the former PNP chief, General Acorda, to shed light on this. Because I will tell you, General Karamat, if you're going to relieve all these people, no, and assigning them to the different parts of this country, there is a pending case. So yung pending case ito, nandito sa korte. Di ba? Asan yung kasong ito? Sa Bulacan? Paano sila makakabalik para to monitor the case that was filed against these perpetrators? Yeah. And assigning them, no, parang I think is not to the best interest of the organization. Unless there is a clandestine, no, effort to really put the case on the garbage. And as a matter of fact, General Karamat, yung kaso ngayon is under RFI, diba? Recommended for further investigation.
Am I correct, General Karamat? Is this under RFI, all the cases that was initiated by Colonel Joshua Alejandro, the regional chief, o siya palang regional chief, ang CIDG, siya pala, si Alejandro, Joshua Alejandro, siya ang regional chief, hindi mo kilala? General Karamat?
Of course I know him.
Oh, that's why I'm asking you a while ago, sino ang regional director ng ano? Ng Region 3. Sabi mo, hindi mo alam.
I didn't say that, sir.
Ano sabi mo kanina?
Your Honor.
Ano sabi mo kanina?
It was Colonel Alejandro yung unang operation against the Pugo
Imbanda. Ito ang tanong ko ulit, General Karamat. Si Colonel Alejandro ang regional director ng Region 3. Siya ang nag-operate. Di ba?
Yes, Your
siya
Honor.
Siya ang nag-operate doon sa Hongsheng Gaming Technology. Sa Bamban. But the augmentation of the people that was used is under Region 1. Correct. And you were telling us a while ago, you were on leave.
The augmentation from Region 1 was a different operation conducted by Colonel Alejandro.
Hindi ang Banban? You're under oath?
We, the CIDG had conducted
wait.
Operation, sir.
Yes. Okay. So yung augmentation ng Region 1 ay hindi sa Banban?
Again, it was the operation led by Colonel Boyaca when there is an augmentation coming from Police Regional Office 1 and Cordillera, sir.
Okay. Paok TF, you conducted this operation. Can you kindly confirm the statement made by General Karamat?
The first operation, sir, I think yung kay Colonel Alejandro, sir, it's a different one. And the second operation, same area to, sir, yung sa Banban po, Your Honor. And the second one, yung sa Sunyuan, sir. Ito, sir, yung kay Colonel George Buyacao. And that's true, sir. Ang ginamit pong augmentation doon are personnel or police personnel coming from Region 1 and Cordillera.
So in other words, yung kay Buyacao, yun ang gumamit ng augmentation coming from the Region 1.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Same question, General Karamat. Why is it during your incumbency as the regional chief of the CIDG, no? Bakit ang ginamit is region 1 not region 3? Do you know this or you're still on leave? Still on leave ka rito?
Again, sir, I was not informed of that operation, sir. That particular operation, sir.
Hindi mo ba napapansin ba't hindi ka na-involve sa operations? Why is that so?
It's only the former chief PNP that cannot answer that question, sir.
And that's the reason why we have to invite the former chief PNP to shed light on this. Because para ako may nakikita ang mga missing link dito eh. I need to be given more information for us to find out the deeper problem arising to this relief of these successful operations. Hindi ko talaga makomprehend kung bakit yun ni-relieve eh. Yung mga tao, pagkatapos, imbis na bigyan natin sila ng pabuya. Di ba? Kasi alam nyo, ako hindi ako police, pero I know for a fact that kapag napunta ka sa NCR, parang ano yan eh, level up eh. Pero putting your people outside, no, after the complete successful operation, that will put a doubt on the transfer. And again, hindi ako. Babalik ko na po kay Colonel Busita.
Kung ikaw ang tatanungin ka, Juan, anong yung opinion sa balitang ito? Mag-iwan ka lang yung komento at atin na itong babasahin isa-isa.
At yun nga mga kabalits natin, yung mga ilang mga patungkol, mga pahayag at pagtugon dyan. No? At kayo lang bahala mag-komento, ukol nga dyan. No? At yun muli, syempre, nagpapasalamat tayo sa patuloy nyo pagsubaybay at patuloy nyo pagsuporta at pagsusubscribe sa ating channel. At syempre, nagpapasalamat tayo dito sa Balita ni Juan, subscribe kayo dyan mga kabalits. At yun mga kabalits, ito mo lang yung WB. Hanggang sa muli natin pagkikita, mga kabalits!